Eric Mwatha with another Rethink video. Today we are going to be taking a look at IPOs, and we are going to be taking a look at them based on the RSI and how you can use the RSI to get entry, or at least to understand if a stock, especially an IPO, has momentum. In this first example, we're taking a look at Twitter, TWTR, and of course we can see here that there was a breakout to new highs on the weekly RSI, hence the reason why it's doing well. But you have to be very careful, given that it is back to the previous high. So even though it's doing well, the one thing we have to always be aware is that it could turn around and have resistance looking like that, confirming that this is where you could get a pullback. But for the purpose of this video, we are going to be taking a look at hourly charts, because IPOs don't have enough data to confirm that they are due for a long range move. So you have to go back to the hourly charts to tell you how you can trade IPOs because of the limited amount of data. So let's take a look at Twitter here, and we can see that there was a nice move and a breakout gap up move here, jumping from about 39, opening up the following day in the mid 40s. So we can see there was a breakout above that wedge. So the entry level was there. We know that as a fact, or on hindsight. And so we know that if the stock ever comes back and holds support on the line, then the stock is a buy for a snapback rally. And you can see here, it did come back to that level, immediately went back above it. This makes that buy signal, which was successful. It touched the same line here, which was that low, and since then it's been up. It came back to the line, which is also happens to be around the 50 level of the RSI, which is that nice entry level. And recently, over the last couple of days, you can see it's formed a double bottom there, which makes this a short-term low, and hence why it's moving higher. So if you use this method here, you can see that yes, the previous entry level here has become support and has given investors multiple reasons to own the stock over the last couple of weeks. Let's go to another hourly IPO chart, and we're going to be taking a look at GoPro. And here you see a nice breakout. You can draw it like that. So there was a nice breakout here, moving the stock from about 46 all the way to the current highs of 66.65. But what I want to look at here is there was a breakout somewhere there to new highs. Hope you can see that. And so that happens to be this level there, which coincides with an entry somewhere here in the 40s. Draw a straight line from that entry level, and you can see that every time it bounces on the line, it's a nice buy level for a snapback rally. It also touched that same level here, which is this nice lows on the hourly, especially if you're a day trader. And since then, the stock is making higher highs. Now, there's another way you can also take a look at this, and we can go and find turnaround situations on the stock. So there was a break there, and that break was responsible for this move down. If we draw a line from the break point, you can see the line has been giving us buy signals. Now that the line was initially a sell signal here, once it moves above the line, every time it moves back above the line, it's a buy signal. Let's test that. Above the line, successful buy signal. Above the line, successful buy signal. Touch the line and went back above it, successful buy signal. Uniform activity below the line, back above it, successful buy signal. Which makes a lot of sense. So you can use the previous break level to tell you that if it manages to go above that level, that it's a buy. Let's take a look at another IPO, and here we see a classic example of a breakout to new highs on an IPO hourly chart. So there was a breakout there to new highs. In fact, there was another breakout even here to all-time highs. The breakout to all-time highs on the RSI gave a nice entry point here at $34. There was another breakout there and a move above 69.10 for the first time on the hourly, which might explain why the stock has had a nice run since then. Okay. Also, we can go back and test. So there was a breakout above that line. Draw a straight line. And you can see that every time we come back to this line here, we get nice entry levels. We come back to the line here, another nice entry level. We bounce on the line there, another nice entry level. If you're a day trader, this method can really help you find nice entry into stocks. So let's take a look at the dailies for the three stocks we talked about. So we begin by taking a look at Twitter. And you can see here, it held above 69.10 on the daily, which is the reason why it had this massive move. Recently, it's moved back above 69.10 here, responsible for a move from about 45 all the way to 52. It continues holding above that, so there's no reason yet to sell it because the daily continues being strong. Of course, you want to be a seller when it breaks this trend line here, which is the RSI lows on the daily. Let's go to GoPro's daily chart, and here we can see again, once it broke out to all-time highs on the daily RSI, also coincides with this move above 69.10, so that was your breakout entry level there, which happens to be also connecting this line that connects the previous daily closing highs. Draw a straight line from that. So your entry level was somewhere here. But the move and the fact that it's held above 69.10 is the reason why it's jumped from 47.5 all the way currently at 66 and change. Let's take a look at the daily for MBLY. And take a look at this. The stock, ever since we have enough data to reflect the RSI, you can see that that has been enough to move the stock from the price of about 38 all the way to the mid 50s, because the daily RSI has held above 69.10. So want to take a look at one more, and it's Twitter's hourly chart, because I forgot to mention something. And what we have in front of us is Twitter's all data hourly chart. All data hourly chart, and the RSI setting is at 26. What I want to show you is an interesting line on Twitter in terms of the previous break level here. But before we do that, notice that every time initially after the IPO, it was breaking out, it broke out to new highs on the hourly somewhere there, which happens to be a nice entry level for a very nice move. There was another breakout to all-time highs on the hourly, so another opportunity for day traders to jump in the stock there, which was breakout somewhere around that level, and it had a nice run since then. Also, we had a spike in the stock when it finally broke out to all-time highs and also held above 69.10, which also happens to be somewhere around there. Good enough to take the stock from a price of 47 all the way to 75. Now, there was a different development in the stock when it broke down and hit a price level there of about 75. So there was a break on the RSI there, which was a sell signal. So that sell signal is at a price range of 67, 68. So we know that was a bearish setup there. So let's draw a line from that level. And you can use a stock's trading history to tell you how to look at a stock. So you can see right there, ever since the stock broke down there, every time it came back to that level, this the red line, you made a short-term high in the stock. You come back to the same level there, which is also this highs. Previous to that, you attach that line there that I missed, which is that high. You come back and make a double top there, which corresponds with these highs. You have uniform activity above the line back below it, short-term highs. It is only after you manage to move above the red line there that the stock becomes a buy, because this time there is no uniform activity back below the line. So entry level there, because it's back above the red line, which is somewhere around here at 35. There was a short-term break again below the red line, which is also a break of this trend line, another sell signal confirming a top. Uniform activity above the line back below it, which makes this a short-term high. And since recently the stock has held above the red line there, corresponds with this move there from 45 all the way to about 51. All I'm saying is that if you use a stock's trading history, you can find situations where you can use that for day trading, especially for those who trade on a short-term basis. If you're looking at weekly charts, then you can use them for swing trades into a stock for weeks and months at a time. You can use it for monthly charts when you see this type of action to enter into a stock for months and weeks at a time. So let's clear all that. I want to show you another way you can also view this chart. There's a lot of information here. So take a look at, there was a nice entry level there on hindsight. Now I'm saying on hindsight because now we know that it made a low here and here, and since then it's up. So we know that this on hindsight was a perfect entry level, that breakout, which corresponds with RSI breaking out there and also this price range. So you draw a straight line from the ideal entry level like that, and you'll see that every time the stock has uniform activity below the line back above it, you can use that as a buy signal, which was short-term entry level there. Uniform activity below the line back above it, another perfect entry level there. So what was an ideal entry level can also be used for future purchases whenever the stock pulls back. And you can use this on any time frame if you understand that principle of uniformity. And you can also use it, as we are showing here, for IPOs. Eric Moore, the good luck, peace, and blessings. Woo!